January 8, St. Peter Thomas, Bishop. It was in the middle of the 13th century that the Carmelites from Palestine moved to the West. In the West, they were introduced to mendicancy and monasticism. When high monasticism was at its peak, in the middle of the 14th century, the Carmelites were blessed with two great saints, St. Andrew Corsini in Italy and St. Peter Thomas in France. St. Peter Thomas is considered one of the greatest glories of the Catholic Church of France. He was born into a poor family in the province of Perigord in southern France in the year 1305. His father was a farmer and he had a brother and a sister. His brother died at a younger age. After his death, he did not want to burden his family by staying there. Therefore, he left his home to earn his living by teaching young boys in the nearby villages. Meanwhile, at Darshan, he studied dialectic, grammar and logic. At Darshan, after his studies, he was noticed by the prior of the Carmelite monastery in Lectoure, and the prior invited him to teach his young clerics. Naturally, he was acquainted with the Carmelite spirituality and he received the Carmelite habit at the age of 20 and joined the Carmelite order. After finishing his philosophy and theology at Darshan, he was ordained a priest. After his ordination, he was sent to Paris to further his studies in theology. After acquiring a doctorate in theology, he was sent to Avignon as the procurator general of the order. At Avignon, he came to the attention of the Papal Curia, and they established him as one of the confidential advisors to the Avignon popes, Pope Clement VI and Pope Innocent VI. Pope Innocent VI would later entrust him with 14 different ecclesial missions for the Holy See. At the age of 49, he was made Bishop of Patti in Sicily. In the year 1356, he brought about the submission of the Emperor of Constantinople to Pope. In the year 1359, he was made legate to the whole of the Christian East, and he was given various powers, including the power to wage war against the enemies of faith. In such an occasion, he found Philip the Messiah, the Chancellor of the King of Cyprus. Both of them became great friends, and thanks to the efforts of this Philip, we have a reliable biography of this great saint, which he wrote immediately after his death. In the same year, 1359, Pope Alexander VI entrusted him with an expedition against the Turks. In the year 1363, he became the Archbishop of Crete. And in another expedition against the Turks, with the help of the King of Cyprus, he was given the title the Patriarch of Constantinople. And in this expedition, he fought with full mind and body, that he returned Cyprus tired and broken. In the year 1366, on the 6th of January, at the age of 61, he breathed his last. Great crowds came to view his body, who acclaimed him as a great saint. He was venerated as a saint, as a confessor, a bishop, and people even invoked his mediation during great pestilence. St. Peter Thomas had a less conventional career, but he had an important place in the history of the Carmelite order. Many of his contemporaries considered him as an ideal Carmelite, where the two dimensions of contemplation and apostolic engagement were blended together perfectly. He was molded into the caste of Saint Elijah because he was a man of prayer, fervent preacher, and aggressive warrior for the cause of God. He became a hero at that time when the Carmelite order was really in need of a hero. He lifted up the Carmelite order when it was declining in fervor and spirit. He had a special devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, whose apparition he had more than a couple of times in various decisive moments of his life. Through his acts of promoting peace and unity in the Catholic Church, he is regarded as the precursor of ecumenism. Prayer. O Heavenly Father, you inspired St. Peter Thomas an ardent desire to work for the peace and Christian unity. Grant that, following his example, we may strive after Christian unity and peace in the whole world. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.